Well, this was an extraordinary gift to me today. It came because yesterday and today I spent all day long listening to a little over an hour's worth of Gandhi and King quotes, tightly edited for just the pithy, extremely enlightening comments on their views of waging nonviolent war. And the experience of taking my efforts to a higher level, seeing what that feels like, seeing what that is. And the key was unlocked when one of my favorite quotes, it's one from Eleanor Roosevelt, came to mind. Any thoughts I've shared and any of the thoughts that the greats in world history have shared are great because they're insights into the truth, how things work, how the forces of life would work. But they're approximations, the best approximations of the time. But they're approximations and they should be improvable upon. Well, in the context of all this, Eleanor Roosevelt's quote, "She who would bring light must endure burning," came into my mind and unlocked the truth that he who would start a raging fire of the heart, a raging fire of sanity to sweep the nation, he who would start that in the next month and a half, because that's all we've got, we need the rest of the time to fan the flames across the nation and the world prior to the 2012 election. He who would do that must bear the heat of a blowtorch, must endure being the heat of a blowtorch. This is a way of getting in harm's way. Anyone that wants to keep coming back to, oh, needless suffering, martyrdom, into pain, please go to hell. Please just don't listen to my stuff. What I'm doing is so far in line with and enlightened by what King and Gandhi and Mandela and others did. Please, please, go to hell. Don't listen to my stuff anymore. Just go away. And more, I hope of such people that they stay alive long enough to see the hatred in their children's eyes for their denial in 2011. I don't wish anyone ill, but I wish justice. I wish that people feel the consequences of their actions. To protect people from the consequences of their actions is to enable. It's a crime against them and a crime against anyone else. This is what a soldier of nonviolent war does. They put themselves in harm's way to become a forewarning or a forewarning of pain to come, or a manifestation of pain being endured by others that's invisible. Because that might, via the royal road of empathy, begin waking up an ever-increasing number of people because if enough people come awake, the problem is solvable. This is extremely helpful to me. I don't know, given the day 6 is feeling like day 50 did last time, that day 5 is feeling like day 49 did last time. I don't know what tomorrow will bring or the next day, except, unlike any prior effort of mine, I'm understanding at a much deeper, much more clarifying level, empowering level, courage-giving level, what this is about. I need to be a blowtorch. I need to be burning so massively hot that a massive fire of unviolent love ignites in the hearts of enough people in the next month and a half that the fire rages across the country, largely on college campuses. That a bonfire is going within the next 4 months, and that we spend the succeeding 12 months fanning that fire across the country and across the world. Those are the dynamics, folks. It's game over if that doesn't happen. I'm always eager for a better way. And I am in all my adult life, ferociously determined. Improper diagnoses, improper prescriptions kill. And I suppose, having spent part of the day in the presence of the McKibben Club, I may well do a video log on that tonight as well. A raging fire starts with a blowtorch. It is a joy for me to have the increased clarity, but that's what I'm called to try and provide. Am I a good enough human being to stay this course with the misery that my body is giving me? Well, it's letting me understand what that misery is about. The greater the misery, the greater the chance that someone's heart will be awakened. And the awake heart is universal. Such a terribly misunderstood point, deliberately so in many cases, because we don't want our hearts awake. The awake heart is not a one-issue heart per se. It's an every-issue heart. But of course it does triage. And no other issue today matters if the spaceship that we all survive on dies in its ability to support human life. No other issue matters right now. The next 16 months will determine whether the life support system on the spaceship dies. No other issue matters right now.